What? What's cold?
The water came back on and it was freezing.
I forgot to put the intro back into the fucking thing.
Fuck it, we'll do it live.
Fuck it! What's up, guys? How's everyone doing? So, Brandon was just talking about how he got to sleep on the couch for a couple of days.
Yeah. Yeah, my wife walks in the house and I was like, well, I saw it, so now you have to also. Here's Rev's butthole.
Now I really hope I never encounter that anywhere on the internet. Like, I just don't want to see it. I don't want to think about it. I don't want anything to do with it.
Oh, just imagine. You get a notification saying that you have a follow request on Twitter, and then you open it up and show me the booty hole. There it is.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Yeah, no. Like, I was in the middle of a stream, and Tara's like, hey, check your DMs. I check my DMs and I just see the abyss winking at me. You know, it's just like, oh, fuck.
Did it stare back?
Yes. And then, no, you didn't win, Fitting Kirby. And then Miss Parker comes in. He's like, Frank, check your DMs. I was like, look, if I see Rev's ass one more time, she's like, check your DMs. I check my DMs and there's Rev's ass again. I was like, God damn it.
I better not see Rev's ass become like the new goat. See, I better not fucking see that shit happen. Like, oh, prank your friends. Yes. Like, no, thank you.
Check your DMs, wink. It's like, ah, shit.
Come on, get the fuck out of here.
Can we at least be happy that he was washing it? You know, like, can we take solace in at least that?
We do confirm that he at least washes it. So.
That was just for the show, you know? That was just for fucking camera. That was the one time he's actually watched it.
You fucking psychopaths. I just spent the last 5 minutes cleaning my asshole.
Wow.
How'd you get that video? Which is funny. Thanks to Bird. Oh, Toast! Toast to Yeah,
I was.
In.
I think that's why it was fresh in my head. I just saw your video, like, a few minutes before we came on, showing all of the behavior that they exhibit as they're talking shit about that behavior.
They're literally talking shit about shit.
Right.
While shitting all over themselves. Literally. That's not an exaggeration. Yeah. Pretty fucking crazy.
Shit. So we've kicked this show off with shit and assholes.
Woo! Alright, I am sending links out to anybody that wants in. Just message me on Discord. So, but what's up, everybody? So it's been an eventful week. Shani doesn't know when she's talking about herself anymore. Like, I watched that whole thing. I was just like, really?
Yeah, like, little did you know that she recorded that entire video in a mirror.
Right? Like, as she was
looking at herself in the phone, you know?
As she was legit yeah. just going through it, in my head, a video was just forming, like, throughout the whole time. I was like, I can use this, I can do that, I can use this. And I was like, fuck it, Toast, I need some shit. And she was like, here you go. And yeah, so... Billy's ass tattoo?
Thanks.
No, Billy had an ass tattoo. Are you not telling me anything? Are you not telling us something, Billy? You got a tattoo right, on your ass says, enter here. Anyway.
Abandon all hope, ye who enter here.
I do want to throw this out. I think I mentioned it before. And me and Monty are kind of sort of stuck right now. Me and Monty are actually going to be coming up with a new show here pretty soon, where it's just, damn it, Jello. So where we, you know.
In the Navy. Hi, guys, I'm F-Gots.
By the way, there was a person with a very similar voice to that calling in a drag show earlier.
I don't know that guy. Never met him before in my life.
I sent you the link, Grampy. But me and Monty are going to be coming up with a show pretty soon. Once nice. We're trying to think of a name for it. So kind of what we do here, so Monty can release some of his pent up energy that he has for some of these little cows. So. If anybody has an idea for title, make sure to throw it at us. So,
yeah, hey, drop your ideas down below. You'll come up with a better name than I do.
Sailors! Oh, goodness gracious!
I got a name for yours in Monty's show. Beige what? Justice.
What's it called?
Beige Justice.
Oh, God. We just combine the two shows and just call it like shit as fuck, you know? Just call it that.
Yeah. By the way, shit. I just want to say that Reb's photo proves to me that we can get the cucumber done.
You got
That's Devin. Yep. So about that picture,
fuck you, Billy. Oh my God.
I know it's awkward and uncomfortable, and no one's going to like that I'm requesting that they look harder at that picture. But here's the thing. Now, this is for science. For science. If you look close enough at that picture, it looks like Rev has two buttholes.
I was talking to Miss Parker, and she said the only thing about his Nigerian heritage was his anus, so...
Gee, Rev, two assholes? Holy crap, that's fucking crazy.
Imagine how many cucumbers. Like, dude, this is your... You're broke and you have two assholes? What are you doing? Start selling asshole on OnlyFans, bro. Come on.
He's got a mole next to his asshole, just like Shani on her forehead, so...
I didn't pay nearly enough attention to this, apparently, as you gentlemen have.
Do you think that the mole came from Shani or not?
Well, Bran, I'm disappointed in you then. I really am.
Yeah, I think that's a mistake.
I mean, you may be right. Maybe I've got to do some study here, you know?
Bran, you need to sit back and just rethink your whole fucking scheme there, Pally. You might be right, man. Yeah.
So Billy has an idea for me and Monty's show. He said we can call it Black and Mild.
That's fucking...
I'm mild, and obviously wasn't that. God damn it,
Jesus
Billy.
Fucking Christ. You know what?
Which did one's, I just walk in on? Oh
which
my God.
One's black? Which one's black and which one's mild?
I mean, that's awesome.
Monty's pretty white, you know? I mean,
oh, shit.
I'm pretty sure that show's going to get you canceled. Just popped in to let you know. Bye.
This is a mistake. At that point, you might as well just call the show Sriracha Names. You know?
What is bukkake?
I love bukkake.
G-Man thinks bukkake is like a glazed donut, which in some ways it is, folks. I mean,
come enjoy my little toaster strudel.
Hey, Brad, do you like strudel?
It doesn't. I don't know.
I know.
What? Wait, what? What the fuck was that?
It was a G-Man insult.
Yeah.
Oh, so it wasn't an insult at all?
No. It was...
Just an insult to be G-Man.
Right. It was something he once heard The Rock say, so it sounded really witty to him.
All I know is I want to join the Navy. I want to dance like Billy.
All I know is I won, Frank.
Not yet. I am doing shit.
How many gifts exist of this on Twitter?
Fuck,
you would be surprised.
On Twitter, look on Discord.
I haven't really used any twice.
I tried to scroll to a bottom of that list and haven't found it yet.
You all don't know how hard it was for me to fight the urge to come on your show using the picture of Rev's asshole with googly eyes and a nose. It's a little bit modified, and I'm so certain that picture will get past the algorithm. It's just up to whether or not people catch it. You know what I mean? Yeah. I really almost came in here with that tonight.
A nice close-up with a smile and a, you know, pair of glasses or something.
Someone should Photoshop winking. Squidward's face on there. I think that's
Squidward's nose. Just Photoshop his nose.
Yeah, sure, that has more floppers than Rev's does.
Childhood. That's a great idea. Just destroy a bunch of millennials' childhood.
Hey, who has more floppage, Squidward or Rev? You know Squidward. What I mean? Yeah, Squidward, definitely.
Slack's another story.
This is horrible. On behalf of men everywhere, I'd like to apologize for you stepping into this sausage fest tonight.
Whoa.
What do you say? More stops on the tour, Grampy?
Probably. Yeah, I'm guessing. Yeah. Damn, yeah, that's getting, it, that's we're going to have to start setting up for 2022 now, man.
Woo! And by the way, Mudrucker, I looked up... the person that he keeps asking me to fucking look for it. I can only find Daddy Likes Mamba, and yeah, that's the...
Wait, what's the name?
The name of the song is Daddy Loves Mamba or something. It's an older song. Perry Combo.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
Daddy Loves Mambo. Yeah. Papa Loves Mambo.
Of course, yeah. Grampy knows what it is.
Mambo number 5. There you go. Do that.
Yeah, Mambo number 5. Yeah.
No. Okay. Perry it's Combo. Not, but okay.
Totally different. I know. Whatever. Yeah, I know.
Because, guys, I am still trying to look for some at least like decent remixes of that are not just like the average like trap, like womp, 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 and then that's it. Like, actually sounds pretty decent. So I actually looked for Perry Como, and that's the only one I found. So, but yeah, anyway. I guess we'll go ahead and start with the old Revy here, you know.
He immediately begins picking his nose. Yeah, exactly, picking his nose.
Okay, just for the sake of relevancy, I think that's a word. This is a little bit older, right? I'm guessing this looks from the hair, maybe 4 months or older, at least.
Yeah. No, this was just a couple of days.
Okay.
Yeah, this came out after he supposedly took his break, right? Like, this is post him being like, I'm going to take a break.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure that this came out as soon as I, like, he tagged Coke. And I just kind of went in and let Coke know, like, his favorite word. It's the same word that Emo likes to use a lot. Not the racial slur, but the...
You mean my name?
Wait, who? Yes. Hua?
Frank, listen, you're forgetting that Gavin KitKats was in that photo, though.
Sorry. Gavin
KitKats.
Gavin likes gravy!
Yeah, no, so what happened is Rev tweeted Diet Coke and essentially... Diet Coke's like, nah, fam, stay the fuck out my mentions, essentially.
I want to be violated. What the fuck?
Asshole. Is that echoing?
It's terrifying.
Clone number 658. His kids won't miss him.
That's true. That's true.
Frank, it was bad enough having to hear like Shanny's witch cackle, and now I have to hear it like in an echo.
Well, that was Mr. Potaint Toehead with Rev's asshole.
By the way, I just want to throw out something that we would be remiss without acknowledging, and that's rest in peace, Von Helton.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. No, people are actually going to believe that if you say that.
No, it's true. It's a thing. He's dead.
The trolls, haters, and naysayers are trying to say that I'm dead. It's fucking bullshit.
They called me a corpse.
Somebody made a fake obituary
Rev
for him.
Rev can't fight the urge of dropping a digit in one of his holes.
Hey, I mean, you see how quick the finger went up his nose.
God, can we go back to the Vaughn's dead conversation? Ew.
I mean, to be fair, he has small hands, so.
Yeah.
At least Vaughn is something happy.
He has regular European hands with floppage.
Yeah.
No floppage.
I mean, his fingers had plenty of floppage when he was all wet brained and shit. He just kind of laid there like a slug.
Hey, he farted a lot, too.
Remember when Danny was like, I love you, baby, and he was like, and then shit on himself? That was great. I love that video.
Good times.
Frank's fucking hiding. We know you're there. Your cat hat doesn't cover you up, my dude.
Yeah. No shit. Young lady, you're probably wishing you weren't in this stream right now. You look very uncomfortable.
No, my face is just very expressive. It's hard to hide how I feel.
Oh, okay.
Welcome aboard.
Yeah, you know.
She watches the show.
Expressive like Rev here, who looks like he hit record and he looks like he got caught picking his nose.
Yeah, I do want to give a shout out to Rev for literally every time that you pause on him, he gives me a frame for like a thumbnail or something like that. Every time I pause on a frame of Rev, it's something gold like this. So thank you very much.
It's always unintentional. It's great.
Jesus, boy, picks his nose more than Stinky does.
Yeah.
I mean, not like Stinky's gonna be picking any noses anymore.
Oh, he
did. From what I heard, he even got his stimulus check taken away from him, and the money was sent to his kids. So,
wait, he got a stimulus?
Oh my God, it's the Freezer himself. Did anyone see Buck lock up in Drag's chat today?
Who is Buck? Is Buck back around?
Sup, fuckers?
Boy, you froze hard on Drag's.
Oh, dude, I got all fucking confused. I'm like, which stream is which? And then, like, is Drag talking to me? And I'm just like, all right, I'm done.
Buck, that wouldn't be the first time. You're a little confused.
Yeah.
But we're here for you, buddy. You know?
I appreciate that. Support is, you know, support's a good thing. Friendship, man. That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Friendship and support, hose.
And Rev's butthole.
Oh, God.
That's what it's all about.
That's not what it's about. It's not about that at all.
And some coke and a smile. I mean, a coke and a smile. Or
there's nothing wrong with being dead, Vaughn. I didn't survive my colonoscopy today.
Oh, shit. Oh, yeah. Mudbrucker went into the hospital today to get felt up and get his.
Apparently, he
didn't sodomized.
Apparently he didn't come through. So
Mudbrucker.
Mudbrucker. What a way to go. Damn.
I can never tell when you guys are joking or not. Jesus.
Well, no, of course not joking. The guy.
Yeah, Mud died. Mud died.
Yeah, Mud just told us. The guy came in and
told us himself he's dead. Would you show a little fucking respect?
I know. The man got fisted to death at the hospital and you're not
fisted to death.
Do you know how hard it is to super chat from the afterlife? Like, come on.
Holy shit.
I'm just glad he got a chance to super chat me last night before he died. You know?
By the way, Mr. United for Children said, rest in peace, Stinky. Rest in poo. Mr. Potatohead said, there's some whoas in the chat.
Whoas?
Whoas? And my wife said, welcome to Garbage Island.
Keep that fucking cow away from here.
Welcome to Garbage Island. Hell yeah. Fuck yeah.
So, Jesus Christ, we even got like 1 second into this fucking
video. Hey, do you think we could get Billy to, like, you know, Billy was in Navy and Billy can dance. He knows all those Navy songs and everything. Do you think he could put a dance troupe together and so we could have like a...
I'm sorry, what?
You think Billy does that thing where you like do the squat and the kicks? You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. All the sailors, like they learn all those.
I think sailors do that, yeah.
They learn all those fucking dances. I come from a Navy family. They knew all those songs. They do the dances. They watch all those old Disney movies with, you know. Yeah, it's crazy out to sea, man. So I just thought maybe Billy could start up a dance troupe, you know, with the dancing sailors and stuff.
Yeah, go serve some people, Billy.
Yeah. Oh, my God, I can't believe I forgot. Happy birthday, Grampy.
Yeah, I guess the birthday is continuing. I guess that's. I informed my wife, and so she was going to go, do you want a cake?
Nice.
I got a cheesesteak and some jalapeno poppers for my birthday, folks.
That's better. That's way better than that.
That's what's up, Tubes.
That is what's up. On that shit.
Can we play the video?
Because
Rev's staring at me.
Yeah. Rev's getting y'all.
Staring at us mid-pick is very awkward.
He's getting me.
So it's a Jason Avocado video. And, you know, Avocado videos are supposed to be really fun. I want to be
fun. Yeah, Jason Avocado.
Wait a minute. It's supposed to be. Whee! Yay!
Avocados are thrilling.
I look forward to seeing you in Skull.
The smiling cow says, hey, Brian, I look forward to seeing you soon.
Yeah, I look forward to seeing you, too, at the fucking slaughterhouse, bitch.
Wow.
I've never heard someone threaten a cow before.
Brian's seeing that cow in his dreams, though. Like, you can't just, like, this is not
Thank
Brian.
You, Jello.
I support you on this one, Brian.
The cow has human teeth, which is just real creepy.
Thank you. All right. See, I'm not the only
Something
one.
Something Shanny doesn't
hey,
have.
Brian, listen, I know a slaughterhouse near you. So.
It's probably one of the very few things Brand and I agree on, and
clearly got a psychological edge on Brand, and that's not fair because you know it's
Vaughn
like arguing with a 4-year-old.
Best
right?
impression of his children.
Oh shit, Nicky Goods. Nicky Goods says, anyone else think Vaughn is just doing his best impression of his children? Oh shit!
God, no. There's no way Vaughn could ignore himself. True.
Sorry about that. Can I just point out that Rev picked his nose, did not wipe it. They ran it through his hair.
Yeah, he does this a lot at the start of every stream. I've noticed this is like an ongoing thing that Rev does. He puffs himself up like a fucking peacock to look intimidating.
So when's he going to do his weird neck thing?
I know, yeah.
I kind of disagree. I sort of feel like he did wipe it in his hair. He picked his nose, didn't wipe it, and then ran his fingers through his hair. That's not what happened. He picked his nose and then wiped it in his hair. That's what fucking happened.
The big question is what's he going to stick up his ass first? He can't start off with a cucumber.
No, like, what happened to a cherry tomato first?
How about a soap? How about a fucking bar of soap?
Well, we already know. I don't know.
Yeah, why not?
Foot and a half of rubber hose.
How about a bleach enema? Because that asshole, man, Jesus Christ, man. Boy doesn't wipe properly. He needs to be cleaned out.
After seeing that picture, I've been using eye drops several times today.
That is some fucked up. Holy, everybody, it's my first asshole shot. It's like, oh god.
By the way, I was thinking, one of two ways had to be that photo would be taken. One of two ways, either Shani had to get into the actual bathroom and take it, or he put his camera on a timer.
I bet Shani took the picture. I bet Shani baited him and taking that picture. Oh, yeah. Bend down and spread your cheeks.
You guys weren't even talking about the other picture where he's like holding his fupa back.
Yeah, what the fuck was that?
Because that gave me more questions than the first picture.
That one confused the fuck out of me.
Real quick, our show for my individual butthole situation.
The slaughterhouse is what Rev calls Shani's crack.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, Brent,
you're still a fucking nightmare.
Brent, I'll send you a list of slaughterhouses near you. Thank you.
Can we discuss the other picture, though? Because I'm not sure what I was looking at.
I didn't look at the picture. I've only seen his asshole, and that was it.
No.
I was looking at both of those pictures at the end of my workday yesterday, and I was like, I thought to myself, how did I get here? What is my life? I need to go take a very long hot shower in this locker room and get the hell home because everyone's trying to scar me today.
Yeah, you're like, okay, I'm trying to picture this scenario. So you're in hip waders, waist high in shit, and you decide to start looking at pictures of Rev's asshole? That's kind of your idea of a good time? What are you doing?
I'm kind of surprised she didn't have to take a cold shower after seeing that.
I took an ice bath.
All right, there's a thing. Like, here's the thing. Like, I'm not like someone sent me the fucking new Twitter is, and I didn't really look at it too well. I just took a screenshot, sent it to my wife, and she was just like, "What the fuck?" I kid you not. I thought that floppage video was his ass crack. I didn't know that was his gut and his fupa. I thought that was his ass crack.
Yeah, I've got a question.
Oh yeah, I know. Yeah, I know what you mean.
I thought it was his vajayjay or something.
I think the second photo was his attempt at a dick pic.
What I don't get is like, why is everybody showing this to like their loved ones? Like, hey, I love you. So I'm gonna show you.
I don't hate my husband enough on a bad day to do that to him.
Because my wife
I don't hate Lindy at all, but I definitely showed her.
I don't want
a divorce. So
hey, listen, I sent it to my boss. So.
And you're fired. I do want to point out here that calling it a fupa on Rev is a bit inaccurate.
Rev is just showing us there's no light at the end of the tunnel.
Rev is just showing us there's no light at the end of the tunnel. Thank you, Nikki Good.
So I've got a question. What's the K stand for?
Oh no, it's a C. It's a fat upper carrot area.
Oh my god! Look at the shirt he's wearing right now. Look at the fucking shirt.
Even babies know. You know, that's what I want. That's what I want on Jason Avocados is a channel where it's just going to be mukbangs and just having fun. Do you know what I mean? Time. That's what I want. Yeah. I don't want any
kind.
Come on,
guys, let's put on a show.
Having a good time.
It's going to be a really good show.
Yeah. I want to be lazy and not put any effort into my shit. And I want people to really enjoy it. And if somebody says something that I don't like, I'm going to throw a fit. Yay!
Yay! Oh, sitting way, on my toilet.
Wow.
By the way, for all you guys that subscribe to his OnlyFans, he's now charging $20 a month. So go ahead and cancel.
Jesus Christ.
$20.
Let me reiterate.
$20 a month to see Rev's asshole.
I would rather lick the ground at my job every single day for the rest of my life than pay $20.
That's why I'm telling people to go ahead and cancel their subscriptions.
Won't have to worry about it for after.
How many subscribers does he have so far?
Well, it was free for the first 7 days. So.
He took that off real quick, probably. He's like,
Man.
Yeah. Stitchy says, I will watch only if he cooks and eats in the potty. That is the bugbang spot. I mean, he's got it right across from him, so.
I mean, since they both piss and shit in the bed, can we consider the bedroom the potty? I mean, how specific are you being?
I want to see him cook while he's sitting on the toilet.
He's got a hot plate in his mouth.
Yeah.
Dude, I just want to see the George Foreman grill in his lap without the grease trap so it just hits him in the balls.
Oh, wow. Hey, I don't know. That might be, you know, I don't know.
Hey, Brandon, you know what? There's a market for this, Grampy. You seem interested. Shit. Hire me, Rev. Call me. I'll be your agent, bro.
I know.
Well, apparently Rev is doing hot food challenges if you buy him the stuff. I just want to point out, he sounds amazing when he vomits. And as long as you're like in the million and up Scoville range, you're probably gonna get him to vomit. I just, you know, just throwing that out there.
Yeah.
Drama.
Frank, you still got that hot chocolate that you can send to him?
Oh, I ate that.
Oh, well, get another one. Send it to Rev.
Why am I gonna buy this fuckwit anything?
That was the best response, actually.
Good point. Okay,
I would buy him some 5X fire noodles and a bag of like ghost pepper flakes to put on it. I'd buy him that. I would buy him that.
I wouldn't fucking buy Frank. Him water if he was fucking on fire.
Here, I'd have a dinner on me.
Frank almost went fucking Wern on him. Like, what the fuck do you think I'm going to buy this asshole?
You think you're my dad and I can show you my asshole?
Wait, by going Wern on him, does that mean Frank was going to yell the N-word until he got him a date?
Oh, that too.
Can you imagine Rev going to the employment office with his resume talking about, I'm a mukbanger. I put things up my ass for money.
Buck made a great resume for him.
Let's feature that.
I saw that.
I haven't seen it. Yeah, let's talk about that. I haven't seen it.
Yeah. Buck, you still got it. It's hilarious.
Yeah, I mean, how should I show it?
It's in Discord.
I compiled
all these videos and got everything all ready, and y'all just want to look at some stupid thing that dude made online in 2 minutes.
Hey, it took him three.
Billy, did you make that? I'm proud of you.
Yeah.
It was fantastic.
I love the videos you put together, Frank. I mean, unless they're about people that I get, you know, there's times I hit, but no, I love the work that you do. It's a lot of fun and you do a lot of great effort. I know that. I appreciate you, Frank.
I'm actually having fun doing a lot of edit stuff. I've been I was researching a little bit today on how to do, be more elaborate with the editing work, you know, stuff that Shandy doesn't know how to fucking do, so. I'm trying to.
Collaborate.
I've got this. Bit in mind where I put baby powder between my butt cheeks.
I got people on and Rev then team were flame.
What the fuck are you on about, Cello?
Hold on. The sister porpoise says I'd pour petrol on Rev if you
sign me up for that. There we go.
All I heard was Jello being like, "Yeah, my butt cheeks," and I'm like, "Oh,
yeah." And baby powder. I mean, who wouldn't be into that? You know,
maybe he's born with it. Nah, it's methamphetamines.
Yes,
methamphetamine.
This is your reminder, kids. Do not do drugs.
Or
his
do.
Hand slipping into the fifth dimension
well,
right now.
Don't do certain drugs.
Yeah,
don't
if you're gonna do drugs, do them responsibly, man.
I can't tell everyone not to do drugs like Rev has, because then we won't have content for the show.
Oh my god.
Fair enough. Touche.
Frank. His hand looks like a goddamn game of Tetris right now.
Yeah, I know. I was like, I was thinking the same thing.
It's like, it looks like Greg Locke's teeth.
Like a blurred out dildo or some shit.
Yeah. Oh, God. He's being censored in real time. Oh, shit.
Tito says Rev's butt picture is actually his application for a new job. He's showing convicts the potential capacity of his prison wallet. Oh.
Hey. Oh my god.
Where the fuck was this divine intervention censorship when Rev's
he's willing to take one for the team.
God took a coffee break.
Yeah, so what the fuck, God? And now I know you're not real.
God's not real. Shut up, Christian.
No.
Rev's butt picture is actually his application for a new job. He is showing convicts the potential capacity of his prison wallet.
That just goes to show that Rev's willing to take one for the team. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, 100%.
Dude, he's quantum leaping in this picture. Look at his mouth.
Oh, shit.
Well, if what people say about I'm his scared. Ass is true too, maybe he can even take fucking two for the team, if you know what I'm talking about.
Hey, who do you think can take more up the ass, Jenny or Rev?
Oh, jeez.
Depends if Rev has those two buttholes. That favorite second butthole.
I don't think you could even find Shanny's asshole, so...
Yeah, that's the real challenge, right?
But there has to be a crevice once you get down there. There has to be a place where poop comes out.
Yeah, you just flop her onto her belly and wait for the dispensary in order to work at
once. Mo says, anyone think Rev is emasculated by Shani's voice being deeper than his own? P.S.
Probably.
You have to be able to pronounce dispensary, in order to work at one. Yes.
Spencer.
I think, I don't know that that's a fact. I
Rev
don't.
Probably went into the place, into a dispensary somewhere, and goes, I want to work in a pot store because I like to smoke pot, man, and everything. And they go, well, go fill out an application. You know, you've got to. Like, when you go in, you know, are you guys hiring, man?
Patted him on the head and sent him home.
The fact is, no one that doesn't go into a pot shop with exactly those qualifications. I like pot, so I want to work with pot. That's why people get that job. Everybody.
Yeah, Rev just didn't get it because he has no social skills and he sucks.
Right.
Emphasis on the second part of that, he sucks.
Yeah. Well, he has to be able to carry a firearm too, and he.
And
can't.
Let's be honest, he'd also have to be going out to willing and like be willing to go get a job. So.
Shanny said he was out looking the other day. So.
Right, I don't believe that because Shanny said.
All right, just as a comparison, right? Like Rev is the guy at the gas station that gets fired for doing the scratch off tickets. That would be him in a pot shop.
Just selling booze to kids as a side gig.
Rev we'll talk about
side hustle.
Rev was probably hustling ashtray for shorties.
Oh god, Chubbs, what the fuck? I'm just gonna let that. So far, he's like he wants his mukbangs to be fun. He doesn't want. He's talking about he don't want us to come over there and to troll and stuff like that. That's
okay, so
really
it's not
going to
be fun.
Oh, my God.
Also,
well, as long as he lets it like that, I mean, then I won't go over there.
Why would you say that if you didn't want us to
do it? He put this as a private video, but then he posted it.
Learn how to eat like an adult and not a child, you disgusting piece of shit.
Or learn how to take some criticism and maybe learn from a mistake or two. You know, like, there's options. He has options, folks. He has options.
Holy shit, Chubb the Cucumber is here, you guys.
What's up, Chubb?
Chubb says, two holes. Decisions.
Chubb knows. Am I a fucking liar or am I fucking? Yeah, thank you, Chubb.
I just want people to know, right? Like, this was originally a private link, but he put it on Twitter, like a fucking dumbass, essentially made it up. Yeah, no, the video. It was a private link, but he essentially made it public by putting it on his Twitter.
That's fucking stupid, and so is dumbass. He.
BS or any of that stuff on Jason Avocados, and that includes the harassment that continues from these stupid assholes from my other channel. that it has nothing to do with mukbanging or anything. It's
well, when you're a piece of shit, people are going to
also.
Figure
what
out
does this have to do with mukbanging?
Yeah. Okay. There's a fair point. Fuck you for your fair points, but I mean, some of the criticisms that he's pissed off about are people telling him he needs table manners. He needs to learn how to use a fork. He needs to fucking use decent camera angles when he's trying to show food. Like, there's honest criticisms of his mukbangs that piss him off.
Don't cook in your bed.
And there's, you know, me going over there saying, get a job.
Wait, is that what he blocked you for?
No, he brought me because I put the video of him calling us all the F slur and telling us to die when he tagged Diet Coke.
Get fucked, Rev. You're going to be showing your asshole on the internet for years to come, bitch. Get used to it.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. I already told him to get a job on that one. Never mind. I was going to do it again. But yeah, so that's why he blocked me.
Politics, religion, and everything that makes people angry. That's what's on Revelation News. So I want to say to my audience that's just mukbang people.
Hi, we're your audience.
Yeah.
Get used to it.
Get out of your fucking bathroom.
Any of you mukbang people here?
Not really.
No. I kind of am, yeah. I'll eat that fucking bullet. I'm kind of
okay,
a mukbang watcher.
Then,
and, yeah.
Jello, I think Rev is speaking specifically to you.
Yeah, it's
here,
possible. It's possible, but what Rev doesn't understand is that's not where I found him. Right? Like I've been watching Rev, and but that leads to the more real point, right? That no people that
casting
watch mukbangs are finding him because of his fucking mukbangs. That's not happening.
MO says casting from the toilet sideways and in a bed. Pay me.
Exactly. Zero effort, much whining.
Exactly. You can't sit there like you can't put out a shitty product and expect people to be like, you know what, I want to pay for this. It's just stupid, Rev. Like
infomercials, Frank.
He's not even good at it either.
Oh
no.
Like he doesn't talk like I don't like Booty Booty. Like I can't stand the way her channel. I'm trying to get into it, but it's just
it's a lot.
At least she's somewhat entertaining.
She's so much more talented of a mukbanger than fucking Rev is.
Yeah, she tells her stories. They're cringy as fuck, but she tells stories and so.
And even if they're bullshit, by the way. Even if they're bullshit, she knows how to work the camera angle. She knows how to lay the food out. Yeah. She knows how to be disgusting that the feeders like. Like, Rev's just a fucking moron eating
Rev
in his bathroom.
Rev just talks in circles, too. Exactly. Yeah. Like, you got it. You hit the nail right on the fucking head there.
Why is Rev looking to the side in this shot?
Probably because he's about to do the neck thing.
Yeah.
Oh, do it. Do it. It's so gross.
Do it.
If he doesn't, maybe Frank will.
I have to DoorDash everything.
Ooh, I love that everybody's picking on Frank's treads, not mine. Rev,
no. You're not on camera. We don't see it.
Chubbs the Cucumber says, Rev and I are planning to redefine mukbang.
Yeah, no, see, I hired Chubbs. Chubb is the cucumber that's going into Rev's ass. We've already worked on the deal together.
Oh dear!
I just soured my stomach. Thanks.
Yeah. So, Chubb, just stick to our original agreement.
That's why I got alcohol. Continue, Frank. Sorry.
I get the whole redefined mukbang thing. I like it.
Right.
Your suggestions, I look at them.
No, you don't.
I will try to do these better as time goes by. I promise. I'm going to do my best to become like a Nikocado Avocado type of channel where he's doing things correctly.
You've been doing this for how long and you still have the shittiest like mukbang channel ever. Like it's the same thing. You don't learn how to do stuff. So.
That's hard to do. The shittiest
mukbang. He actively
mukbang.
Bulks fucking like when people are giving him those honest criticisms, like I said, about his manners, about the camera angles and all that. When people give him those, he throws fits. He calls people evil.
He's a child.
Because any suggestion or constructive criticism that people try to give him, he he takes as a personal attack, and then we're just haters. No, we're trying, like, people are actually giving you decent suggestions, and you're too lazy to piece of shit to make a change.
Again!
Ooh.
Again!
Rev versus Steve McRae, moderated by G-Man.
I'm out.
Who's the buddy says Rev's life is a revolving door of mukbangs and yuckbangs? True.
Right.
Yeah. We've seen how they take criticism just the other day when they legit yeeted the fucking Celeste Kitty out the damn out of their chat for just saying, hey, respect is earned, not given. And they're like, she's being a bitch! And took her out. And was like,
yeah, there you go. That's not earning again! Respect. Right there, that is not earning respect.
Rev might auction that thin G between his nose.
Nope.
You heard it here first, folks. Rev and Shanny yeeted a cat.
So I
was it Gavin?
I just kind of got a little bit of an evil idea. Like, oh God. Someone was just saying bang. And bangs in reference to this young man right here. And what if somebody gave him enough to get a bob haircut, and then every video we can look at him, we can look at him with bangs. I mean, look, his hair's going to be greasy and gnarly anyway, but if he had bangs, I think it would be adorbs.
It's going to look like a donut with all the hair in the middle.
Did you say adorbs? So, am I the only person who wants a Gavin Keycats Shanny t-shirt?
I'd buy that shit.
I totally want that shirt. I want to wear that on stage, like, when I perform.
I'll buy it, but only if somebody else besides them makes it.
Yeah. You know what, deal?
Bootleg Shanny and Rev.
Legit, I made a Cloppy t-shirt, which I'm going to make a better, another one, kind of a little bit of a newer design. But people bought the Cloppy t-shirts. I'll do a Gavin's Kit Kat t-shirt.
Gavin Kit Kats.
I'll take the photo.
He likes gravy.
Dude, Gavin's the best part of that channel. Like any of their channels. Oh, yeah. It's fucking Gavin, man.
Yeah, the way that he stares with intense hatred to Rem is great.
Right?
Why
I feel that.
Has anybody thought of maybe putting a collection together and getting Gavin his own bowl so he doesn't have to eat out of a can anymore?
You know what? If I do this, like, I'll have like 100% of the profits go to like the ASPCA. Or
can I treat stream the cat? Is there an option for Gavin Kit Kats?
I don't think any place in America serves cat legally.
Oh, it's about time that changes.
So I don't care how much you want it, nor how
go
much
to your local Chinese
like
place.
You are not getting.
That's racist. What if I like get some Red Lobster and specifically say it's for Gavin?
Oh,
they're gonna eat it.
No, you'd have to get it past Shanny first, man.
Yeah, you know what happens to them in that house.
They legit got a $30 tuna sandwich on their treat stream.
$30
$30 sandwich.
I don't know, like, where it's from. It's $30 when you go
wait,
to fucking Subway.
That's got to be not canned tuna. Yeah. Like, if that's actual tuna, then I guess I kind of understand it. But does that belong on a sandwich? Like,
no.
Like I mean, I'm just like, I love a nice rare tuna steak just seared on both sides, you know? And I, yeah. Oh, but I'm not trying to put that between slices of bread with mayo. Fuck that. I just want the tuna.
But yeah, you get that, and then it's just.
Because you're not into the carbs.
And then when they don't give it to Gavin, it's fraud. I don't know.
Exactly. Like, I'm down. Shit.
Yeah, no.
I'm down.
Now I want some fucking tuna. That's delicious, don't it?
He's flamboyant. Yeah, he's funny. Entertainment.
Talking about Gavin.
Yes.
It looks like Rev's got a giant gash in his head right now.
Fuck that, man. Look at his tongue.
He is a giant.
Oh, my
gash.
God. Look at that kid.
Got him.
I think the giant gash is still in the bedroom.
Oh dear!
Oh God!
Speaking of that, where's Frank?
You know she never gets up.
True.
Well, I mean, she had to get up to take that picture.
Speaking of gashes, where's Wilson at tonight?
Present and accounted for. What do you need?
Drunk and passed out on this couch.
There you go.
Things correctly. He's flamboyant. He's funny. Entertainment.
That's what they used to call gay people in the fucking 70s.
On Jason
all
Avocados.
In. That's all yeah. in.
Charles Nelson Reilly. He's flamboyant.
Here's the issue, Rev. You are none of those things. You're not entertaining. You're not funny.
So. Gavin Kitchen.
Definitely not flamboyant.
Look at his eyes.
Did you catch in that live stream? I think it was yesterday when he's like talking about people are calling him gay and he's like, I'm not gay, I'm a Christian.
Yeah, I remember that.
What the fuck?
I'm not gay. I was like, I'm a Christian.
You know those. That's not how any of that works, but okay.
But look at his eyes. He's looking up like a, pardon the pun, but like a cat looking up at its own for food.
Yeah, he looks like Gavin Kit Kats right now.
Don't you dare compare him to Gavin Kit Kats.
I know, man. That's not right.
How dare you?
God, man. Yeah,
why don't they ever talk about watermelon anymore?
Watermelon, I think watermelon. Like I have a strange feeling they ate watermelon.
You know, watermelon's alive, but he's like the kid's cat mainly.
But they never talk about watermelon.
Well, that's because watermelon's black, right? So they keep in the back.
That's a joke, right?
No, that's not a joke. They named it black watermelon.
I think it is a joke, but it's a very bad joke on their behalf.
Thank you.
But no, it is what they did. Yeah, they named the black cat watermelon.
I'm convinced that they ate those guinea pigs.
Oh, I gotta know that.
Well, you know, you get a good skewer and a good hibachi grill.
Yeah,
you
some
know,
great some guinea pork chops.
Sweet right and fucking sour sauce, a little bit maybe. You know?
A delicacy in other countries, folks. A delicacy in other countries.
Yeah. It's like giant fucking balls of chicken, you know?
What?
I mean, I'm getting really hungry. This stream is killing me.
I want some General Tso's chicken. I'm thinking of that right now.
Wait a minute. His lip still hasn't healed.
Dude, it hasn't.
Hamsters.
I really, really would love some tuna, though.
This sure. actually looks like the look he gave before his lip was resplit.
Yep. I was going to say before he lost his virginity, but you know what? Pretty much the same thing.
We don't know that he's actually lost his virginity. I mean, we know that he's probably splooged on something, but we don't know that he's actually hit Shanny's pee hole yet.
Look,
okay, well, to be fair, both of those things happened to the same person, right? Shanny was supposedly involved in both of those acts. Only one of those we have proof of.
Look, we
know the only thing we know for sure is that Shanny pissed on Rev's face. Okay.
Yeah, the porn that they made, you're right, we don't know. But back when he was retarded and she was, you know, screwing him without his consent, you know, that I'm pretty sure she was hitting it then. So I think we can assume he actually has lost his virginity, just whether or not he knew it at the time.
Unwillingly, yeah. True.
So, Anna, you thought...
You see Shanny fucking flopping Rev around on a bed. He's passed out with his Revelina makeup on and shit like that. She's going, step come here, you dirty boy.
Hey,
that's how Rev found out he likes to eat ass.
Oh, Mo says, Rev has underpants gnome syndrome. Step one, I want to do X. Step two. Step three, I can now profit from X, and if I can't, it's everyone's fault but mine. And then, Gavin, Kit Kats donated $1.99. I took a photo of Rev. Help me call the
Oh, shit.
Hey, Gavin, Kit Kats, blink three times. Blink three times, just so.
So, Anna, so you thought that was bad when they named her Black Cat Watermelon? Here's what they... This is her little fucking... Stardew Valley bullshit.
Yeah.
Guess what they named the chicken?
Yes. We put your food in there, Gary.
Oh,
Gary.
That's a good Gary.
Oh, I've seen this, yeah.
Wait a minute.
Yes, he's a good Gary. Good Gary the chicken.
Gary the chicken. That's awesome.
And yes, I named that chicken after G-Man. I'm just saying.
wait a minute. Now wait just 1 second here.
All right, wait, it's goddamn register.
I think to me, maybe it's just me. That's a little bit sus. Okay,
it's racist.
As the kids
fuck.
Say,
yes.
Suspish.
Wow.
Yeah.
Chicken, black,
dairy. Oh, God, they're going to say I'm racist.
How?
Because it's a chicken.
Oh. And black people like chicken.
I did it because I was thinking of him at the time. Because something, we have like a really amazing announcement.
And watermelon.
Grampy,
okay, not even she actually can't help herself.
No, like, shit.
It's not something she can prevent herself from.
And that's what I said. That's why. Yeah, I know.
But you know what? Here's the crazy thing about that. If I saw that out of context without knowing the watermelon thing, I'd probably be like, I'd give her the benefit of the doubt. But that was just, you know, Shani, considering you've done that, you've named a cat that, yeah, I'm not going to give you the benefit of the doubt. You did that for maybe even unintentionally fucked up reasons. So,
who's the buddy said Rev lost his virginity the moment Shani pegged him the first time?
Yeah. Oh, no.
Nice.
I still want to see that on their OnlyFans, on his OnlyFans also.
Yeah.
So could somebody
on there?
I want to see video of Rev like half comatose with the Revelina makeup on and Shani flipping him around the bed, making him do really crazy shit.
I'm pretty sure that type of porn is illegal.
You know what, Grampy? How high are you exactly right now?
I'm not as fucked up as I was last night, but.
Well, no shit. You were drinking like THC Everclear. That's some next level fucked up.
That's
that was a crazy night last night. I gotta tell you.
Damn, yeah. Grampy's awesome.
Oh, Grampy, if you want some tips on Tinker, I could talk to you sometime when. You know, we're not.
Okay. Yeah, because it didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. I got enough to get fucked up a few more times because it doesn't take much of this stuff to fuck you up. Because I don't drink, you know? Because I only drank like little shots of that shit last night. And that stuff fucked me up fast, man. God damn.
Yea, though I walk to the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For YouTube is with me, your mods and your laughs, they comfort me.
Aw, that's kind of sweet.
Horns and jack and whatnot. Oh,
shit.
Very biblical.
Very biblical. Kind of makes me want to convert.
All hail Grampy's conversion.
Oh, shit.
Horns and jack.
Prayers in the chat.
God, peanut I needed gallery some prayers stuff. Early this morning, I'll tell you that much.
Peanut gallery scumbags from the other channel, please go away. You are not.
You know the origins
here,
of peanut
anybody
gallery.
That's
like
nope, in the muck.
We're not going anywhere. You're canceled. Sorry.
He is so hell bent on getting Shani to be famous and popular. You know, because she's got talent, folks. She deserves 1 million subscribers, according to Rev.
Oh, yeah, because Rev's too fucking stupid. He doesn't know that we're half his audience now.
No, we're 90% of his audience, and this stupid ass is telling us to go away.
I know. I mean,
I want people to watch my videos, but you guys can fuck off. Well, us guys are all that's watching your videos.
Joe, not exactly. You have Shani and her kids.
I said 90%.
I seriously don't think Shani's kids are watching that Rev on YouTube.
Oh, I bet
hey, you. Dad. That's my dad.
They watch Shani.
If anybody, but they're watching that cringe fest.
Oh, you know all the kids at their school, man. This is probably something they all watch every fucking day.
Oh God, dude.
Kids are brutal. Man.
Oh, here comes the Dorn kids.
I remember what it was like to be a kid. If their classmates know about these two idiots, I would want to be dead. Oh my God, I couldn't even imagine how horrible that must be.
You can't.
Fuck.
Can't. What's next?
That would be awful.
Whew.
What?
So I have to tell you something.
Oh my God, look at that sourpuss look. Look at that.
Dude, Mia.
This actor Frank ruined his Coke deal.
I'm a failure of a man.
Folks, that is an accurate and correct statement.
That tank top always reminds me of a stretched out Baywatch swimsuit.
Makes him look like a parrot.
It just makes him look like a failure. He's got a tank top that's all stretched out, probably a few sizes too big.
Oh my god, can you imagine if he dyed his hair green? Because he's had his hair green as the Joker before, so imagine if he wore this tank top with the fucking green dyed hair.
He'd be a real carrot.
I need a little bit of context from Frank. Is this video the same day? Because his hair looks just as greasy and it's the same shirt.
Let me see.
Or is clothes within the next 3 days, because the shirt does look a bit more wrinkly and stretched out, so he might just keep wearing the same shirt for, so I don't know.
It can't be as wrinkly as that Batman shirt, though. God damn.
I mean, do you really expect people change their clothes or shower on a daily
basis? No, I don't. That's why I'm asking him, because I want to know time references.
There's no need to ask.
Well, I need time references.
You know the answer, Jello.
You already know.
So the answer is in the question.
Wearing the same clothes gives me no hint whether it's a week later or the same day or anything. So
They use the shower as their food cupboard now, so it's kind of hard for them to.
Their food cupboard.
All right, so from this one was 2 days ago. This right here. He's been wearing this since about 6 days.
So no surprise there. He's
fucking monstrosity right here. So,
all right.
Well,
eating a salad, a mukbang, a salad from fucking Target, man. And
actually,
what was it? That frozen French bread pizza. Jesus Christ, Shani brownies. Oh God.
Was that the one that looked like her period was coming out of the brownie?
Yeah, it looked like it. Yeah.
Can I just
say,
I think we found her favorite shirt.
Orange.
So, I have to tell you something. Shani's Twitter is gone.
Ha!
Yay!
They have to decide to unsuspend her account, which I can't even remember what she got suspended for.
Tried to get me banned from Twitter the other week. How's it feel, bitch?
Welcome to the list, yeah. Oh, man, attempted to be banned by fucking Shani on Twitter too. Welcome to the fucking club, because that's multiple goddamn people. Anyone she doesn't like, that's what happens to them eventually, it seems like.
Well, they deserve it because they're
messing
with God's favorite daughter, you know.
Can I just add that although I've stated many times I don't want to get them banned or kicked off of any media site, although I've said that, I only really pay attention to them on YouTube, so I kind of would just assume they weren't on the other sites. So yeah. I don't mind when they get banned or suspended or whatever from other platforms. That don't bother me at all.
Hey, yeah, Jello, I'm really getting tired of being saluted tonight, man. I'm feeling really gay right now. And
what? You're welcome.
I got my pants down. I'm saluting and everything. Can you change that gif finally, okay?
Hey, salute your shorts.
I am.
Grampy, where's Mrs. Lobster to take care of you at? Where's she at?
She's asleep.
Wake her up now.
I can't. She told me to leave her alone tonight. She goes, "You're weird, you know." Wow, that's hot.
Is this better for you, Grampy?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
As long as there's a beard involved, you know.
Oh, let me go get my husband.
This is Billy 6ix9ine.
Yeah. Wow. Tag team with Billy and Bran. Wow. Gee whiz.
Again!
Oh, fuck that. Again! Billy would be the snitch.
I want Shani to be banned from the candy aisle.
Take it to the candy shop.
Shani's team will be banned from the candy aisle.
God.
But she's gone. They caught her. Making a new account. So she's gone. If she gets unsuspended, I'll let you know.
Peace. This is going to last like 3 days, just like it was on YouTube.
No, you can't come back on Twitter, man,
She didn't pay her phone bill, so she can't get into Twitter to appeal it.
She's just probably going to create another account like some other people that we know on there that have been banned many times.
So wait, currently Shani's out of commission and Von Helton's out of commission?
Yay! I think they still have their internet, but I know that
nobody's heard from Stinky since he went that noise on the internet.
Nope.
Oh, you didn't hear?
No, I heard. I was watching some stuff this morning about. I was watching the replay of Secular's thing from this morning when
J-Dub's
stream got hijacked. Or
yeah, nobody smelled stinky in a long time. It's fucking crazy.
Normally that'd be weird, like away from here.
Yeah. Rest in piss.
That'd be wouldn't it be weird if that's when Larry decided Larry finally snapped during the middle of that stream, and what we heard in the background
the frost
was like,
are here.
Yeah, and then you know,
just Larry beating the shit out of him.
I feel like Von Helton rests in piss every time that he lays in his bed.
Valid point. Valid point, actually.
I don't think Vaughn's probably washed those sheets since Mouse was there.
You mean since they were bought?
You think he even has sheets?
No.
Oh, Jesus.
You think he even has a bed? He just has a hamster wheel.
No, he's got that bed at the corner where he throws everything, like his dog.
You know? Oh, yeah, right? Yeah. Over there.
Vaughn has rubber sheets and a weighted blanket to keep him from thrashing at night.
Hey, Jello, look, I've had that same problem before, okay? So
night terrors is a bitch. I get it.
Plastic sheets, folks. I
gotta eat my dog. Gotta eat my dog.
Oh, this is great. Frank, the original name for the town in Clay County that Vaughn's in is the same name of your town. That was the original name of it.
Onita?
He lives in Retardsville, too?
Yeah. What the fuck?
Who gives a fuck, man?
Stare at the abyss.
What the fuck? You know, like, look, this is why I wish Rumor Research was still around. What the? I've never, like I said, 80s folks, a little bit of fucking eyeliner, hair, things like that, Aquanet. But what the fuck did Shani do to her fucking eyes there with that purple shit? It looks like somebody punched her in the face. Uh-huh. You know, there's nothing. I've seen a lot of women that can do colors with makeup and it looks exotic and looks really
I've got a controversial opinion. I know this might, you know, be pretty fucking controversial, but I think that a makeup job this bad is a domestic violence situation, honestly.
It is. I mean,
don't understand what you're looking at. This isn't like what you would wear to go out to the club. This is an artistic look. This is Ursula from The Little Mermaid.
Like, oh, fuck no. Ursula was way more attractive than this shit. Don't you see her? My favorite villain.
Come on.
No, this is self-harm. This
Ursula at least was in the Screen Actors Guild, okay?
No, it's artistic. It's,
You can't even come up with an excuse that's funny. Like, you know
what I mean? Jello, just because you live in the artsy-fartsy part of the country with the... up in Washington with the Starbucks coffee and all that stuff. You know, doesn't mean you know about the artsy-fartsy stuff there.
Ban Grampy for doxing me? What the fuck?
I said was... I didn't mention that you lived in Oregon.
Hey, crustaceans rights.
Idaho, get it right.
Crustaceans rights.
I can see Billy living in Idaho. That's kind of a right-wing fucking... because he's got those racist tattoos on his arm.
No, Wyoming is the most.
This makeup is just an atrocity.
It's not nearly.
As someone who's super into, sorry, I'm gonna just be a bitch here. As someone who's super into makeup, this is just. She doesn't do anything all day long. Why isn't she watching makeup tutorials? She has expensive ass makeup. I can tell you,
she's a beauty guru.
Is not cheap, but she looks like she just dumped her face into Grimace's pussy. Like I just don't understand.
Less more like Hobgoblin.
Oh, wait a second! I thought Grimace was a guy.
Doesn't matter.
Grimace doesn't have a gender technically.
Oh.
Wait, you mean?
Yeah, but how do they make little grimaces?
Maybe he's asexual. I don't know. Okay, I don't like to assume. Maybe Grimace just licked her face. I don't know.
I mean, hey, Grimace used to have multiple arms. Maybe he used to have multiple dicks.
That's you never true. Know. I mean,
or multiple vaginas. So why
what's her like the other day when she painted herself that whatever the fuck that was supposed to be last week.
Crusty Jabba the Hutt?
What was
a dead Smurf they dragged out of a lake.
Yeah. What goes through so many, I mean, Okay, first of all, what was she trying to do?
I don't know, but I think she Avatar. Used liquid. She used liquid latex, right?
Yeah,
or something like that. Yeah, you're not supposed to. You're not supposed to paint that on you. Like the way she just looked crustier than normal, which it says a lot.
And she sat there, and it was like, yeah, it was like the shape of Jabba the Hutt. And I'm not far be it from. I don't make Star Wars references. Not a big fan, but you know, but still, did that shape the way she was sitting? It's like her body kept going. Her like her on her ass area, like when the at the bottom.
Oh, no,
you ran out of picture space. Yeah, because that ass was still. It's like what the fuck did she think that? And when you don't give her the response that she expects. I'm surprised she's not claiming that we're sexually harassing her right now because she painted that shit on her fucking milkers or whatever the fuck those milkers. Things are.
Udders. Udders. Don't call them that. Don't call them that, please.
I like milkers. Milkers is my favorite.
Frank, can you press play? I'm going to analyze this makeup as I'm sitting here and y'all are talking.
Please do. A woman's point of view with makeup.
Woman that loves makeup. Go ahead. I'm ready.
I just want to say she looks like Uncle Fester from fucking Adam's Family.
Uncle Fester and Grimace had a baby.
Let me get my pop culture.
Yeah, but Fester was a nice guy, though. You know,
I think Shani having the freshly socked eye look is almost like a gift to me. Like I say, thank you. You people are sort of unappreciative.
Hey, no.
Thanks a lot, guys. Now I'm just thinking about Fester fucking Grimace.
No, I literally think that fucking Heath Ledger's Joker has, like, more... Like, seriously, the fucking Joker does have more, like, thought put into his makeup than this. And the entire point of that fucking movie is that it's supposed to be unwieldy. Like, you put it all together in 5 seconds. Because that's what you did, Shani. You put together this makeup job in 5 fucking seconds.
No. You know, try. That's what makes it worse.
Well, good. She at least tried. I wonder if she was wearing that makeup when she convinced Rev to drop his pants and spread his cheeks. It looks like Rev gave her those so we can see his asshole.
Just like he did the cops.
Because I don't think that was Rev's fucking idea. I'll bet you Shani was like, hey, Rev, hey, Jason, come on. Why don't you take your pants off? I don't want to. Come on, you little pussy.
Do it. Come on, Revelina. Don't be a bitch.
Yeah.
Shani cuts those wrists.
And he was probably crying a little bit. And afterwards, he goes, "You told me you'd let we could have sex."
I'm just imagining, like, in a courtroom for the divorce, the fucking prosecuting attorney's like, "All right, Mr. Egroff, now where did she touch you? You know, like the doll that they give the kid."
I'm not sure. I'm sort of feeling like we just
those aren't milkers; they're sour creamers. There is no milk in those rotting bags.
Ew! Gross.
I'm not saying horns in chat for that. Shame on you.
No, you were talking. What did it say? Come on. Somebody repeat what it said.
I think Frank's muted. He's talking to us.
Fuck, he's muted. That's why.
There you go.
He finally muted.
Smart guy.
Judging by the color around her eyes.
Frank, I think you're still muted.
I'm about to mute you.
No, he's not.
It looks like Rev gave her those.
Frank, did you know you were muted a minute ago?
Jesus Christ, Grampy. Oh my God.
Hey, Frank. How
Jesus, where's the love from last night, folks? I'm already getting dropped out of fucking streams again.
I love you guys. Anyway, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Looks like Rev gave her those riffs just like he did the cops. And Hoosier Buddy says those aren't milkers, they're sour creamers.
Okay.
No milk in those shit. Bags.
Come on, that's gross. Like, thank you for the donation, but that's
no
gross.
Shit, man. I had some sour cream.
I mean, it's also true, though. Like,
sour cream is good. I just don't want a picture of it coming out of Shannon.
The Rev strikes back.
Shani did touch
Well, that's why you buy Daisy, a dollop of Daisy, you know, that sour cream, because it doesn't come out of Shani. It comes out of, never mind.
The great value kind comes out of Shani.
I don't get a dollop of anything out of her. Anytime anything comes out of her, it's probably more of a splatter. I'm sorry.
We stop talking about things that are coming out of Shani. I'm going to be sick.
I'm sorry, Shani.
Would you prefer that we talk about things that are going into Shani?
Nope. So you don't want to?
Maybe.
Do you not want
to? How about things we can put up Rev's ass, like a head of lettuce?
Would you rather?
A head of lettuce.
It's not going to survive.
That was really quick and very specific.
It's going to be shredded lettuce by the time it gets in there, man.
How about like a corn cob? Like a corn cob that's fresh off the
floor. That'll clean him out really well.
I think it says a lot. It says a lot. All the objects in the world that Grampy could have possibly said, and he's like, yep, a fucking head of lettuce. Exactly.
I'm really ready to get back
it's
to
like
the
he
video.
Thought about that for a long time. He's like, I'm going to say it.
No, I really didn't, Frankie. You know what you're talking about. I was just virtually looking at the produce section of my head going, oh, there's the iceberg lettuce. I was going to pick romaine, but the iceberg lettuce is like bigger around.
Yeah, he's not good enough for romaine lettuce.
Yeah.
Celeste Kitty was eating the salad, and now she just can't eat it. Damn. I really do. You're
welcome, Celeste.
One clip of Von Helton, and he's literally making excuses on how people don't get
clip,
sick
bitch.
When they're around fecal matter.
People are always interrupting. We never get a chance to watch these videos fully. Because somebody's always interrupting, and I think
usually
that's really
all could that be?
Usually, all of you. Listen, okay, I got thoughts.
Thank you. At least she's not the only one. Everybody else is just throwing me under the bus.
She really thought bringing that purple down that far was a cute look. Bitch, you look like for once Rev got to actually throw a swing. Like I don't.
That's why I'm saying I think it's a great look on her. I think she should go around with this like. More permanently done, in Minecraft.
Just get it tattooed on your eyelids.
Nope, that's not what I mean. That is not what I mean.
I got a question. Is that the lighting, or did she choose a foundation that's orange, or...
It's the lighting. It's the foundation.
All I know is that forehead mole is a popping today in that picture, dude.
Isn't it, though? Yeah, it's out there.
Man.
Notice me! Well, the one here... No, the one on top and that one on the side of her chin, those two really like to compete against each other.
Yeah, they're fucking.
No, the one on the top is trying to run away today.
Girls as she is.
Man, don't you wish you could be like Shani?
No.
In pig shit.
Everyone just instantly said no.
A little advice, Vaughn, and. I've had dealings with CPS because of retards on the internet.
I bet. Because you're a bad mom.
Because she used to let her kids fucking shit and piss on the floor. Herself, her own mother talked about that, and her own father. I mean,
and she also
even Chris.
Sex toys.
Yeah. Like what?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's why they got taken away the first time.
She let them play with what?
Sex toys.
Dildos and stuff like that.
Sword Chris fights. Had to basically marry her to help her get her kids back.
Damn.
I mean, it's not like they were clean, but it's not like she was using them at the same time. Come on, guys.
Yellow, no, please. The yeast infection that those things had.
Wouldn't that destroy a kid, though? If he found his mom's fucking sex toys.
How
young
were they? Like, because small children put everything in their mouth.
Small.
Stop, Jello.
Yeah.
What?
Let's not
stop
even go
right
that far.
There.
Jello God is being sexy tonight, man. I gotta tell you, man. Pants off for Jello.
Did someone say canceled?
That was just a fact. That wasn't even a joke.
Well, well, well. We meet again, Jello.
Well, well, well.
I knew this day would come, and here we are.
No. Well, Jello, who is that dude? Canceled. I hear that voice every now and then. I don't know that guy.
Hey, who's this guy trying to fucking imitate me, huh?
The hell is that?
It's a peanut smoking.
Well, what?
I thought it was a guy crying. I thought
this
crying.
Guy trying to imitate me or something. What the fuck is this, huh?
Who the fuck are you?
Who the fuck are you?
I'm the one who's about to cancel you, bitch. That's who I
am. Oh, fuck. You're lucky you're in Canada. Or I'd come across the border.
Going to tell him or no?
Oh, God.
Jesus, I'm not that stupid. Come on, really?
Wait, what?
Jeez,
what
this is really... Grampy's being tricked right now. Fuck. God, I'm trying to have a little bit of... Jesus.
Oh, no, why?
Thanks a lot, man.
I can't believe you fell for it.
I still want to know who this guy is that's fucking trying to imitate me, though.
This is Shanny for Christ.
No, the guy, the peanut-looking motherfucker.
Do you have black eyes, Grampy?
Huh?
Did someone hit you?
Hey, what my wife does to me... Well, I was bad. I was wrong. It was my fault.
It was the slurred speech. That was like, I think...
It was my fault, okay? I'm sorry.
Frank, you did this to yourself. I just want you to know. Yeah. Also, I win. But go ahead, Frank.
Just let y'all know, we're still doing this disenchantment.
You let a girl beat you, Frank?
Woman. I am a woman. Watch it.
Oh, come on, Helen Reddy. Shit. Jesus Christ.
Ew, you know that. But a little advice, Vaughn.
Sorry.
Stop making excuses about the shit on the floor.
You gotta pay extra for that.
Where does the line start?
Yes.
I'm not really sure if there is one.
It starts wherever you want, but you gotta, pay.
I will pay $5 for a good smacking from you. What?
Okay, Frank, that's my fault.
But... You gotta let her have a side gig. There's nothing wrong with that. She's a working girl. She's gotta hustle.
I play in shit, after all.
What? And why are her fucking ponytails lopsided?
Because she's stupid.
Pigtail.
Do you expect them to be somewhat even?
Maybe because she doesn't ever, like, get up off the bed, she sits a certain way, so she's kind of tilted all the time.
They're never ponytails when she has them. They're always pigtails.
Pigtails.
You know, isn't it just like every time we have a woman on this show, they always beat around the bush, and they don't really tell people what they're really thinking and stuff. And I think she needs to open up a little bit and tell us what she really thinks about Shanny. Because I don't think she's being honest. And this is a show, folks, though this is a C show.
You want me to open up? It's not going to be pretty.
It's a safe place, man.
It's a safe place. Don't worry.
It's not a safe place.
It's the opposite of that.
Jesus Christ.
It's the hateful zone, man.
You will be
I don't want the geek room to get canceled.
It's the fag brigade.
Whoa!
Canceled. Right, get him the fuck out of here.
Hey, we get called that all the time. So I mean, it's not. Jesus, man, tough crowd tonight. Fuck.
Is about the shit on the floor, and just clean it up. Shut up and stop talking about it.
So you should do that too.
Yeah.
Well, she just lets him do it. She doesn't talk about it. Her mother does.
She does not take her own advice.
No, like, she
will fuck up and talk about it every time. Every time. My husband loves me so much. You know what? I was stuck on the toilet. Like, she said that. I didn't know that until she opened her fat face.
And she's all, I mean, okay, we also know that, I mean, for the fact that how big she is, it's probably hard for her to, like, wipe her ass. We know that she can't wipe her own ass.
What the fuck is happening?
Because she told us.
Please tell me he's doing
what is that?
What's wrong with this?
That was wow.
Is this some Ultimate Warrior parody or something? Please.
Yes. No. It's just Red.
It was a
Red.
Comic.
If you really want to hear it, it's just him.
He tries so hard. Folks, you got to admit though, he tries hard, and his little fucking feeble mind. He's like, look, I'm going to do something really crazy. You know, so he's coming up with these things. Yeah. Hey, look at this.
I'm on the internet.
Let's just make that known.
Hey, bros, you got to come down.
I'm on the internet, guys.
That's all.
He watches videos, right, of people acting a certain way, and then he wants to, like, copy that.
And
it's so, yeah, exactly. He has no fucking idea who the fuck or what he even is. Because he's always trying to copy something.
Well,
he's always
human.
Trying to... Yeah, I mean, I seriously doubt Rev has no fucking idea. Seriously, I mean, who or what the fuck even... Oh, sure, he's a Christian, he's a truth or whatever the fuck like that. He doesn't even know his own personality because he's always trying to be something else. He's always been trying to.
Fuck is he doing here? Is this like a fucking Ultimate Warrior thing or something?
No,
this is
what happens when you smoke too much.
He watches something on the internet and he's copying shit, you know?
Monkey see, monkey do, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that's the fucking thing. That's the thing about Rev, is that he's always been like this too. He literally altered part of his vocabulary to be more like Brett Keith.
Yep.
And
okay, the whole situation thing. And
look at the garbage pile.
He changed his name, right, to Jason Avocado for some fat guy that shoves food in his mouth in his car and does really stupid shit. That's got a shtick. He's got a gig. The guy makes some coin, you know. Don't get me wrong. But, you know, that's what, there's the crapper. That's where Rev's
a pile of garbage on the floor of his bathroom.
Isn't it like an Arby's cup?
This is the garbage island, isn't it?
What the fuck are you doing, Rev?
That's what
I was like, yeah, I know his fucking
milkshake
garbage. I know.
That's where he does. What the fuck?
He thought this was a good fucking idea.
Is this the video?
Oh, no, it is. It's a great idea for us.
They live in a three fucking floor, three level townhouse. And he lives in his fucking bathroom.
Oh my God.
Sideshow Bob.
This here is a promo for a fucking horror movie. If I
Jesus. Somebody. Somebody take a picture of that. Somebody please take a picture of that and send it to me in Discord. Please. I need that picture.
This needs to be, he needs to be fuzzy with pointy green ears. What we have is a more human Grinch. This is a slightly more
human Grinch. Hey, Bran, I found your next
one. Boy, that's a good scar on his lip, man.
Dude, no, that's not his lip.
That's his lip was just fresh.
How many times do you think Shanny smacked him in the face like that?
I think Shanny's busted his chops quite a few times, let's be honest.
By the way, Brand, there's your next video for your horror
channel. Stockholm Syndrome.
Dude, I don't do snuff films. This is real life, man.
Fair enough. No, wait.
Jesus, Brand. I watched you with a fucking food grater, man. I wouldn't put anything past you, Brand. You sick fuck.
For someone that doesn't like the trolls and whatever else he calls us, he filmed this shit.
He baits it, yeah.
Because showed us his bathroom and just the straight up trash. And he had to have edited this, right? And he saw that and he look at this.
He did this live.
Cigarette pet.
He did this live.
I'm pretty sure this is the video before.
Hey, those are some hip pants, man, though. You know what I'm saying?
Is this he made me bitch at us for him cleaning his bathroom.
Yeah. This is I think this is the video that started it. Like,
I think there was one other video too. Like, I remember him because I remember seeing
Arby's cup
bigger, like an Arby's cup, and I remember seeing like just a lot more. Maybe not.
Yeah, that was in the bedroom. That was in the bedroom, wasn't
it? Hey, where'd that peanut guy go?
Peanut.
Jesus fuck. Okay, now I'm really fucking confused.
What?
There he is, Grampy. There he is.
I thought that was... Okay, it had Wilson's picture on it, then it had your fucking picture on it. I mean, I'm sitting there like, what the fuck? I thought Wilson was in here, and then he's not, right? And then it's like...
You want to know the funniest part of this whole
thing? Yo, is he having like a senior moment or something right now?
Yeah.
What's going on here?
Yeah, that's what's happening.
Jesus, there's Wilson. Fuck me. Oh, God.
You know what the funniest part of this whole video is? He has a moment of clarity, but he was pissed at us when we all pointed it out.
The full thing going on, folks. I clean up the bathroom.
He realizes his bathroom is dirty. He's like, I got to clean up the bathroom. And so when everybody pointed it out, he does this
like one. Holy shit, you people are fucking psychotic. You know, I just spent some time cleaning up my bathroom because harassers on the internet will make
look how the lights are off so you can't see it.
Yeah, I was about to put on
the lights. I don't believe you. I totally cleaned up.
Leaving a comment or two on a YouTube video telling you that your floor is fucking full of trash is harassing.
That's why you only let people see what you want to see. I mean, you don't see the little I mean, my little trash can over here probably needs to be emptied right now.
It's retards like this that think that an adult can be bullied on the internet. When all you have to do if you don't like what someone's saying about you is click that little fucking red X, you bully me. No, you'd rather sit there and fucking cry and try to get people to feel sorry.
But he did clean his bathroom, though. Jello, you're really animated tonight. Are you okay?
I'm sorry. I'm a little bit agitated. You're right. My bad. I'll try to take it down.
City of the Silent need to be clean because the internet called him out on it. So.
Do you need your dick sucked, Jello?
You guys are freaking psycho. Are you offering?
No,
but it sounded like,
ladies and gentlemen, I see a love connection happening.
I see a sex tape in the future.
We have opportunities here at the dumpster fucking dive fucking hand job emporium. If you're looking
at stuck by a crustacean
dumpster dive.
Wait a minute, Grampy, why don't you hire Rev?
Speaking of
hey, look, we have standards, man. You
that's
know.
Fair. That's fair.
We have standards. I mean,
I wouldn't want mouth herpes either. It's all right.
No, I mean, and we don't hire people with like front butts. I mean, yeah.
Oh, okay, so it's a classy hooker. Yeah, it's a classy.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're not the classiest. Like I said, we do have standards. You know, you have to draw the line somewhere. Our standards are low, folks, but.
Grampy, what is the address for this? And I'm in no way trying to get this.
And I have no fucking idea.
He's you think smart
I was going to say, why do you think I think that far ahead?
God damn it, Frank.
I kind of lit. Yeah, oh, my wife's terry cloth robe is dirty. No, it's not.
No,
that's
such
the way.
Oh, I remember this. Yeah, the robe was horrible.
He looks so sad. Look how sad he looks.
There's the neck.
It's like they used it as a food, like a towel.
I think he doesn't want to get
that. He does that neck thing when he
that
lies.
That neck thing is weird.
It's his tail.
It is his one Tourette.
No, it's not. I'm telling you, it's a tell. He does it when he lies. That whole he starts out making the video saying that robe is not dirty. Neck thing. I'm telling you.
Let's play him in poker. Let's see how good
I'm telling you, my wife is gorgeous and not fat. Neck thing.
She did not bust my lip. Neck thing.
The head pops off like a Pez dispenser.
Do you remember that video where they were sitting in their bed, which is all of them, and they were talking about Foodie Beauty or Chantel or something.
Oh,
and Reb just made that comment right at Shanny, and he goes, I don't like big women like that, right? And Shanny just gave him a fucking look, like
a death stare.
Yeah, hold on. He goes, I don't like women that big, you know. And Shanny's bigger than one of those girls, you know.
No, she's bigger than both. She's taller.
We're talking about
Foodie is like 5'2"-ish and probably about 400-ish pounds. So,
damn.
Shanny's 5'9".
There's still hope.
By the way, how quick Frank was on the draw.
I know, right? Because I remember what you were talking about.
Plagiarizing your own shit, huh?
Yeah.
Like, seriously.
Copyright claim.
Like,
stealing our content.
Like, baby. I wish you would realize this. I'm not attracted to dudes.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm just saying it's the same thing as playing Fuck, Marry, Kill.
Yeah.
It's the same thing. Would you smash Chantel? No.
Oh, wait, Fuck, Marry, and Killing? Okay.
Here it comes. Watch her face.
I don't like that. She's too big for me. Smash Chantel? No. Sorry.
What?
Not my type. I don't like that. She's too big for me.
I was waiting for it. I could hear that song in my fucking head.
Okay.
You know what? As somebody that like uses a lot of that, that's a very that would be the song that I would look that something.
Yeah,
perfect,
no, that
like
was perfect.
Yeah,
that was perfect.
Also, didn't Shanny claim that she's like 5'9", right? She's 5'9". She said something about being like 200 pounds. There's
270.
There's no fucking way either way, no. Because I'm about 185, 190, and y'all probably have seen my Twitter. There's no fucking way. I'm 5'8". There's no fucking way.
She's close to 6 foot, and she's got to weigh 500 pounds.
It's not 200. It's not 300. I can tell you that.
I mean, guys, listen. She's going to be famous, but it's just TLC hasn't gotten there yet. All right.
Exactly.
She hasn't got to that 600-pound mark yet.
Not yet. Almost.
It's going to happen.
Fingers crossed, guys. So amazing
to see her on that show, though. God.
I just want to see drag like helping Dr.
I don't think she can make. I don't. You know, if Shani made it on a show like that, I don't know that they'd be able to do it because I think she would be too demanding.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yep, which would make absolutely. It an episode.
I think she, because she already considers herself a celebrity. So if she, and so.
Well, they would look, take one look at her online life and they would drop her because TLC. Like, there's no way they'd be like, oh, yeah, she'd be perfect for basically a family channel. Yeah.
Right.
Put her on the TV.
What'd she say about black people? Oh.
So, Rev's wearing a different shirt. This can't be within the last week.
No, this was last year.
Yeah, take a look at his hair. He's got green hair in this video, right?
Yeah, that was making a crack at Rev not changing clothes often. But thanks, guys.
Where the fuck did you get that
green? Mr. fucking literals.
If you have to explain the joke, it's not funny.
Yeah. So they're on Jello, it's gonna land, man. That's what a lesson I learned all too well.
Jello, when was the last time you changed shirts?
Shenandoah.
I mean, I haven't worn a shirt for 6 days, so nah.
I have not either. I'm just wearing a jacket.
I've had
dealings
with
you.
Whoa.
We know. We can all imagine. We saw
you on cam earlier.
We saw you on camera, so we can imagine you wearing all sorts of different outfits. Okay?
It doesn't matter.
My
imagination
is very good. I don't want to know what you're wearing. I just like what I think you're wearing.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, my fucking God.
Yeah.
Are you into shark fins?
Well, anyways.
No.
See why I don't want to hear what you're actually wearing? My ideas are much better.
Jesus, now we've got two fucking Wilsons in the side chat. Which one's the retarded one up top?
Yes.
Don't talk about my boy like that.
Two Wilsons.
Yeah.
I see three.
Okay. No, God damn it. Fuck. Who's the one right under Frankie, the one that looks a bit retarded?
Wait,
there is three. Okay.
Yeah, there's one under me as well. There's one under and over me.
Yeah, but the one on top, the one under Frank looks a little bit retarded. You know,
I got Billy 6ix9ine's gat sticking underneath one of Wilson's ass.
The one underneath Billy kind of looks.
Just like
know.
Hannibal and Mondays, we don't do things here.
The one below,
suck it, Frank.
The one below Billy looks like he rides a short bus, too.
I think you just talked over a super chat there, Grumpy.
Doesn't matter. I'm sorry. It's Team Fit and Kirby. Suck it, Frank.
Frank will read it if we give him a chance.
Who's the buddy says, I'm going to promote the best thread on Twitter again between Fit and Kirby and Frank. And just like Hannibal and Monty's, we don't do teams here. Also, hashtag Team Fit and Kirby.
Thank you. She thought
I wasn't going to keep up with it. I'm still doing it during the show. So
is this going to be that us against them things like with emo? Yes. So if we like Fit and Kirby, we can't like Frank?
Also, I have bigger biceps than Frank. Continue.
Oh.
She might.
Cool.
P.S. because of retards on the internet, too.
So we've got to make a choice between Fit and Kirby.
But Frank's got better tits.
No, lying slander.
Yep. I don't know.
Oh, right. Oh,
right. We're going to have to have get up on camera.
We're going to have a tit off.
Yeah, exactly.
Hold on. Continue, Frank. I got it. Hold on.
Someone make a poll.
A little advice, Vaughn. Stop making excuses about the shit on the floor and just clean it up, shut up, and stop talking about it.
Yeah, you're fucking the one to talk, bitch. I know, like, I'm just gonna address the elephant in the room.
She couldn't even fucking clean up her own puke.
Exactly.
Hey. drop it and just clean up.
Get her
shit.
Son to do it.
Okay.
The one that's a little bit.
Stop complaining. Stop bitching. And just.
When have you ever cleaned up my puke? On Christmas, you dumb cunt. On Christmas, I cleaned up your fucking shit.
On Christmas.
I made this fucking point to Frank before we even went live, but Shani, if you are above Von Helton, it's by like one fucking millimeter. Like, it's not by much. You don't have any fucking, you know, you're not in no position to judge anybody, even the people below you.
What's smaller than a millimeter?
Lower. On Christmas Day, she'll clean your puke.
Oh, God.
It's amazing how much she needs to take her own fucking advice. Like, everything that she just told Vaughn could totally be turned inward.
And she's filming this on a phone. So she's literally looking herself in the fucking face while she's doing this.
You know, that bruise on the left is a little bigger than the one on the right, man. Somebody didn't punch her.
Yeah. I think she's got it squinched.
I'm not advocating domestic violence, people. I'm just saying the bruise on the right is a little smaller than the one on the left.
This isn't domestic violence, all right?
Okay, once again, folks, we're not here, like, making fun of people who actually self-harm themselves.
The thoughts and feelings of Grampy Lobster do not necessarily represent the thoughts and feelings.
Right. All I'm saying is that bruise on the right side of her face is a little smaller.
All we're saying is she shoved her face into Grimace's pussy. Continue, Frank.
And door hit the fucking door. Her eyes hit the doorknob not once, but twice. She didn't learn her lesson the first time.
Shadow said she filmed this this on the phone that's turned off, because that's a thing.
Clean up the shit.
Yeah, I got turned off yesterday.
Okay, it's that Wait simple. I don't understand what it's with little rich
Channies,
little rich boy. These spoiled little rich boys where they can't take any type of constructive criticism, and you say, hey, can you do this? Because this is like this. You go into your ego, you have a temper tantrum, and you don't let it go, instead of just saying, okay, following the order, and just shutting the fuck up.
No, but she's talking to Rev Proxy of Vaughn.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, 100%. Like, look where she's looking. She's clearly looking at Rev right now. Look at that.
Looking at Rev, or looking at his stack of clothes, or looking towards his car, or something like that. Like, I'm telling you, she is talking to Rev through Vaughn.
Exactly. You know, as long as she's not talking to Gavin Kit Kat, it's okay.
Gavin's a good boy.
Gavin loves his gravy. Folks, we need to get Gavin a bowl, you know, a dish, because they make Gavin eat out of the fucking can. You know, and I don't think that's right. Just because they like to eat out of cans and take out, you know, a cat deserves to have like its own dish,
Wait a minute. Is that why his lip is always split? He keeps fucking cutting it on a can.
Yep.
Yeah.
I think it has pretty much to do with them living.
Well, that and
fucking mountain air, dude. It's cold. It's fucking and he perpetually licks his lips.
And Shani not. He irritates Shani a lot, and Shani's got to, like, punch him in the fucking face.
Your lips is not the way to take
care of
that's
what he gets. Lip. He asked for it, you know?
Shani slap. Super effective.
She only hits him because she loves him.
Make sure to give Frank Thigh money.
She makes him, he makes her do it. Like,
that needs $8 for cigarettes, folks.
I never will get it. I came from a very neglectful and abusive background. And when I see someone bitching and complaining because they have to clean up something
like
without
yourself.
Any violence involved,
like, my mom
was
trying to make me
thrown
clean
on the
up.
Floor, being told to
was
clean
she
up.
Going for a Harley Quinn look right here?
No.
Yeah, okay. She is.
Could we go back to the video where Rev is calling people psychopaths because he had to clean the bathroom because people commented on what a fucking pig he was? Because that's exactly him throwing a fit at constructive criticism. Oh my God. It's videoception, I guess.
You mean to tell me that Reverend's a fucking hypocrite? Holy fucking crap.
Specifically that she's a hypocrite, but she should be telling this to Rev and off camera. Instead, she's going to like put it out on the internet towards Vaughn, and everybody's going to go, bitch, You should be telling this to yourself.
True. Very true.
God damn it, Frank.
This shit and being beaten to a fucking pulp. No.
You know what? It's kind of funny. She says that. Hold on. This.
She says a bunch of words.
Yeah.
And that's.
Words have meaning?
Yeah.
No, of course not.
Wait, is this trucker hat, Shanny?
This was made after this video. She was talking about.
Wow, different color black eyes, man.
Wow.
Because people made a comment about it and about maybe Rev got physical or something like that after she just said, we used to get beat to a bloody pulp. I don't know. Then she makes this.
The answer to your question is no. Words don't have meaning. People have meaning and intent. Words have definition.
And this is Shanny before she goes deer hunting.
God, you know what? For all the drugs that Jell-O's done, and for as dumb as some people think Jell-O is, and just crazy and things so like dumb. That.
Just kind of low-key insulting Jell-O there, but
okay. He does. He's smarter than people think, folks. I mean. So at one point, he did pay attention. He did have some retention. That just proves that drugs aren't totally bad for you, folks. See, I turned it around into a positive for him, okay?
Yeah, somehow. Congratulations.
Jesus Christ, man. You
spoke I'd have preferred a simple fuck you. Just saying.
All right, let's dive into Trucker for Christ here.
Oh, God.
Going out there and trying to make it seem that Rev is beating me. First of all, I have to go and say that is untrue, because if he was beating me, he wouldn't getting any far
Why
in the beating.
Why is she doing a fucking accent? Like, for a serious... I assume she's addressing a serious accusation here, and she's like,
I think this is
right,
one of her, like, multiple personalities she has.
Yeah.
This was also...
It's just like the southern one.
She also...
Authoritative, Shanny.
She also hijacked his Twitter for the Jason Avocados one, just to make this one.
This is like communist revolutionary Shanny.
I don't know. It totally just kind of threw out the whole thing of where Rev was like,
"Oh, this is like Fidel. It's like Fidel Shanny."
Yeah.
Fidel Thornbush.
This is the guy that drives around with a fucking dead deer on the hood of his car. That's what this looks like.
Him, because I would be going into ultra freaking psycho freaking defense mode and just Hulk up and probably tear his head off if he ever tried to do something like that.
No, because he would take one swing at you, not that he has any power behind whatever fist he has, and you wouldn't be able to get up off the bed and chase after him. So one hit, he runs, he out, bitch.
I just want to point out that those welts that the cops saw that were from apparently the quote-unquote sex whip, those were defensive wounds. Those were on his forearms. That's what happened. Those were on the bottoms of his forearms. That's what happens when you try to cover your head. That's just saying. Like this isn't a guy that hits her. This is a her that hits a him.
The best part, or I suppose the worst part about it is that, she doesn't even address this in a fucking serious tone. She just comes on here, she makes that be an entire fucking joke, and that's all it is to her. A joke.
Well, I think it's kind of funny.
To me. Or do you not know that I'm Shanny for Christ, and I don't let men
for
or
Christ,
women
I don't
or anyone
no
walk
shit
all
from
over
nobody.
My...
Entire internet.
Yeah, I don't let no man. My name is Shanny for Christ.
Oh, the roping is riding his ding dong and his rattle.
Let me tell you,
I need that fucking video, man. Jesus Christ, an opening. No shit.
It's just funny. She claims that, then she also claims that she gets beaten. So it's just like,
please.
I got nobody.
Please don't.
I also noticed that she's like, yeah, I would never beat Reverend, but here's how I would do it if I was going to. It's like, wait, what? I mean, why do you have to bring up that little detail? It's like, I couldn't even do it if I tried. Why is your
Ironically
mind even there?
Enough, I think that matches the police reports.
Wow.
Oh, God.
Fuck. Oh, God.
See, this is what happens when you give people social media, man. You expose retards.
So, question, are we going to report Reb's account since she's on it illegally or what? I mean, like, it would be the right thing to do for Twitter.
I think that would be up to an individual.
Oh, this came up today?
Not to sound like Rev saying individual, but I think that's a decision that each person should be making, you know, by their own accord.
We're not condoning or encouraging.
Yes.
Again!
Boex?
Again!
That's right.
Again!
You're welcome.
Hoa!
Oh,
I don't have that one.
No, Vaughn, that's not happening. Ass you continue. Had CPS come here, say, oh my God, there is fecal matter on the floor. You didn't pick it up. You should have been smart enough if CPS came to clean it up before they even came. But no, you were lazy. Oh my God. So don't complain about
it. No, okay, listen. If there's fecal, I'm gonna rage.
If there's fecal matter,
no, I'm gonna rage against the machine. If there is fecal matter on the floor, you're welcome for this still of her. Screenshot it. If there's fecal matter on the floor, why aren't you cleaning it up immediately? Listen, my dogs have gotten sick because they get into shit they shouldn't be into. I understand. It happens. I get it. I work in literal shit. You clean it up immediately because it's a sanitation issue, you dumb cunt. I said it. I'm sorry. Not sorry.
Vaughn doesn't get that, though. Have you heard his excuse for it? He's like, yeah, no, I've worked in horse stalls before. I've worked out with cows.
I work in literal shit. I've worked with horses. I have dogs. Don't even come. Listen, I've been avoiding all the Vaughn streams because Frank wants to torture me at some point with the best of Vaughn. Listen, I got good questions.
Vaughn was using his bathroom as basically the shit stall for his dog. So he was letting the dog shit all over the bathroom, and he was using the term shoveling shit. So I'm sure he wasn't going in there every day cleaning up the poop. He was waiting. It's like, on Wednesday, I'll go in there and scoop up the poop.
Wait till it dries out.
Yeah.
Wasn't he also saying his dog is an inside dog?
Yes.
Both of my dogs are inside dogs, and the only time they shit or puke in the house is because they get into something they shouldn't be fucking getting into,
right,
you dumb asshole.
He lives in the country, too. I mean, it's like...
Frank, I got a feeling I'm going to rage. I'm going to rage.
I really want you to.
And do you think Vaughn thought that by leaving the dog next to a toilet, it was going to teach itself how to shit in the toilet?
He's so stupid. I have so many thoughts on this motherfucker. His name, the light worker, is enough to send me over that. Frank, play the video before I lose my shit.
Yeah, that's some weird new age shit.
No, we're not going to get into the pagan shit because I will ream him a new asshole.
It's not paganism. It's something else.
He's an eclectic pagan. He's from on the right side, you know, like Tucker Carlson.
About it. There was crap on the floor.
I'm going to go
clean it up. Stop complaining and stop.
That was one thing that, like, when my kids were little, especially even to this day, I'm sure I can call them. Like, A, I never had CPS at my house because there was shit on the floor when my kids were little. I never had CPS at my house to begin with. Okay? So I don't understand. I've never had to deal with CPS, but if you have shit on that, I don't know, that's just so weird. I never heard, you know, it gets so bad that Child Protective Services has to come out to your house because there's shit all over your floor.
And he didn't do anything about it too. Like he's like, oh, I knew what she was going to say.
He didn't think. Apparently, she's never owned a dog before, you know, because dog shit, you know, it's not human shit, you know, it wasn't like it was my kid's shit this time, it was dog shit.
Cow patty.
This time.
Yeah, and I'm like, what the fuck is this guy, statements like that, he should never be allowed to have his kids. Yeah, I really, you know what I mean? I mean, fuck the whole idea about feeding him correctly, getting Jerry's check, spending the money frivolously. He doesn't have the mental capacity to take care of a fucking goldfish.
Yeah. I don't know if you're Grampy, I don't know if this was ever told to you by your parents when you were younger, but have you ever heard that expression, hey, we don't live in a fucking barn, take care of yourself, clean up after yourself?
No, we don't live in a barn, close the door.
That's Vaughn's standard for living, a barn. Like, he's like, okay, well, cows shit all over the floor and, you know, barns and shit like that. So who cares, right? Even then, people tend to, you know, pick it up.
Yeah, but born in the barn was the whole, like, keeping the door open. Born in a barn, that was...
It's okay to feed fucking dogs chocolate.
Yeah, he goes, oh, yeah, my dog chocolate all the time. They, oh, Jesus, man.
So, it's a wonder why he hasn't fed his kids fucking Drano, because he saw it on Prison Planet or some shit.
Jesus, fuck.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Born's in chat.
Born's in chat.
Born's in chat for Bleach, guys.
Said Drano. It's different.
Or Bleach. Or shout out to Clorox.
On the internet, Clorox, trying to make excuses about poo being on the floor.
Poo!
Oh, God! Maybe you'll get better looking in CPS eyes if you wouldn't talk like that and be like, well, I wanted shit on my floor. It didn't hurt me. I've been around pig trots, and I've been around horses.
Oh,
all of it, bad shit all over the
Shanny
place.
Is
well,
a
what
pig
trough,
trough
and what horse stable did you go where there's a bunch of poo all over? Because the stables and pig troughs I've gone to in my life, they clean up the shit.
Clearly
so
not
clean up the shit. I just realized something. She's trying to be us. She's trying to do like what we do with Von Helton, like ripping on him and like critiquing him. She's really trying hard to be like what we're doing right
hey,
now.
Hey, Shandy, you're about a couple of weeks too fucking late.
Yep.
God, just figuring that out. God damn. Shandy does these every once in a while.
Well, I uploaded it onto my channel, Underhaven Gold, where I post occasional clips of Von Helton and shit like that, and I guess she found it. Cause
isn't the time for the fucking... This isn't the time for, like, throwing out fucking plugs yet, man, okay?
Okay. Damn. Well, I mean, maybe...
You're getting ahead of yourself there, youngster.
Shay should just plug up her entire channel, shut it all down. But
that's I agree. Why?
Do you really want to see Shanny plug anything up?
Oh, come on. Don't take it in that direction. I was trying not to.
Shanny can plug a lot of things up if she fell into.
But she can't wipe her own ass.
That's true.
I'm just imagining Rev with a crowbar trying to get her ass off the toilet.
I thought you were going to say you were imagining a crowbar in her ass. I just.
There's a new thing for Rev's list. There you go.
Oh, please don't make it about. No.
Well, that might be next. We don't know. You know, I mean,
they are
kind of having a problem with money, folks. I mean,
I'm not kink shaming. Everybody has their thing. I just don't want to participate in watching said thing. That's all.
Foex. Forks.
All I know is blame Billy.
Ooh, I got that one too. Here, hold on. Wait, shit. Mothra. But I got this.
Billy likes sausage.
He loves sausage.
Damn right he does.
Fuck Billy!
Sausage. I saw the fucking commercial today.
Billy likes sausage.
Yeah. What kind of sausage?
Also, I just want to take this opportunity. Frank, I won.
What?
How many people are annoyed by Frank and I's jiff off? But I didn't even mean to start, but I started this shit, and I fully intend on finishing this. Frank, you're not gonna win.
Again!
Again!
Gogurt, salute for Vaughn.
Oh my god, come on.
Yeah, we should do a benefit for that guy.
Oh yeah, you know what? We could have, like, a bunch of people go out and get some Go-Gurt, okay? We could have, like, a 21 Go-Gurt salute to Vaughn.
Everybody get out a cup of SpaghettiOs for Vaughn, something like
that. Yeah, or a Go-Gurt.
Avengers Go-Gurt. It has to be.
Right. No. Well.
Geez. Oh, everybody got Schwann's in their area?
Nah,
hey guys, Schwann's in the chat.
Schwann's in the chat.
I don't even know what do I do for that. Schwann's in the chat.
Put a swan.
Schwann.
Yeah, fuck it. Supposed to thing.
Also, I did want to like. I forgot what I was going to say earlier, but now I remember. Like, Shanny has been getting kind of this little, you know, like this bravado because you know, Rumor Research Lab, not here. The resting thing, the body cam footage, is mm-hmm. not upping, but I'm just going to say, hold on, let's see if we can pick up.
Oh, I think there's a few people that still have it.
File for the Freedom of Information Act. Just put in a file for the Freedom of Information Act to have it released.
I don't need to do that. All I have to do is just pull it. Hold on, where's that? MP4.
It's the Wait freedom up. From Frank's computer.
I got it. It.
Oh, God. This is absolutely beautiful.
So, just
give that man a Baja Blast.
He got Baja Blasted already. That's what their fucking problem was the first time.
Didn't he drink his bong water?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh,
that was a great video.
Vomit.
Yeah, it fucking looks like Dookie water. It's disgusting.
Well, that shit that I was drinking last night didn't exactly taste like fucking fruit punch.
I mean, hey, you know, it got you where you need to be, though, right?
I don't and beyond, man. God damn.
This here isn't terribly timely, but when she's telling Vaughn about how, you know, CPS coming to your house and seeing shit all over your floor isn't like people trolling you or whatever, she could take that advice too, because this is the woman who, when asked about the time, because she claimed to be swatted, right? And when people in her chat asked about it, she said, well, the first swatting was a 911 call gone wrong. A 911 call gone wrong. This body cam footage that Frank was just showing, that is
right.
That's the fucking time that she's talking about. The 911 call gone wrong. Yeah. The reason that went wrong is because she called 911 on Rev, but when the cops got there, they noticed that he had been beat and not hurt.
He had defensive wounds.
Jail. So that's the gone wrong part. And it wasn't trolls that did it. It wasn't a swatting. It was the neighbors that, you know, called them for like domestic shit in the apartment because they're yelling it late at night.
You know, Rev had defensive wounds on his hands.
Yeah, and as soon as they took her outside, the first thing she tried to do is throw him under the bus.
Oh, yeah.
Why isn't he getting arrested?
Yeah, why aren't you taking him to jail, too?
Bitch, you got fucking
crazy. I can't believe you're arresting me and not him. And the best part about this is, yeah, you know what? You might be such a terrible person that you'd throw your significant under the bus like that. But those kids were not old enough to just stay there in bed. So if those cops have to take both those people, those kids got to be hauled, you're gotten up and then getting by the social worker and whatever. Like, oh my God, fuck you, you selfish cunt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Amen.
I don't disagree.
Mm-hmm. I'll concur with that.
That's the only shit I had today. She also admitted to the police on footage that she hit him twice. Yep.
Yep.
Those might be slowly making the way onto my channel. Unlisted in my nice little Rev and Shane file.
How? Okay, first of all, I think Rev has realized that he's done this shit, and I don't think I think he knows he's stuck in this shit for better or for worse now. Just for all the, you know, what?
Rev's already thrown the money away.
Like, yeah.
Speaking of throwing money away, Frank, you're welcome.
When do you think Rev realized that he was just fucked?
All hail Fitker.
I mean, I think it's been a while.
If he had any brains, he would have left the moment she called 911 on his ass. No.
He has no brains, so yeah.
I'm not saying he did, but
no, also true.
Yeah, that he did say if.
I think that she's convinced him that everything gone wrong is basically pretty much, yeah.
I think Tab is going on. Fuck My Life is going live in just a couple of minutes.
Yeah, with Mrs. Parker and Black Eye TV. So go check that shit out.
Fun.
Yeah,
that's gonna be fun.
All right, yeah. So we're gonna go ahead and start closing this down. Gary Cool Shades.
That's me.
I know that's
you. Oh, just the way you said it. No, I do have something to plug. Stay tuned. I've just started working on our band's new Bandcamp page. Much to my chagrin, it's a pain in the ass, but we should have some stuff up and running here, hopefully, in a week or so.
Well, I'm sure it'll suck.
See,
I mean, yeah, I'm sure it'll be no. I mean, I'm sure it's going to be great.
Why don't you tell us how you really feel, Greg?
Yeah, right. Like,
no, I like.
I love it.
I like some of his music. Some of it's pretty good.
The ending parts is your favorite, right?
Yeah. Right that's when awesome. He stops singing, that's when I start caring.
Yeah.
Anyway, Fit and Kirby.
Pretty much.
Oh, fuck me. Sure. I am starting to put content up.
Oh, my
God.
What a way to die.
I mean, these things happen. I had to scrap some of my footage for my first video because it just is shit. But I am going to start putting stuff up on YouTube. And if you want some cringe content, you can check me out on TikTok or on Twitter as I win against Frank. Because, Frank, I won. You lost. Just take the loss.
We're still going.
Dude, you realize we've been going since the 11th, right?
Yeah, it's been about 4 fucking days.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Okay, I'm done.
Get a room, you two.
No shit.
Never.
Grampy.
I like to do this shit out in the open. Thank you very much.
She's an exhibitionist.
I want everyone to see. Everyone needs to see. Okay, I'm done.
The only way.
Go ahead.
All right. We got to wrap this up, Grampy.
Sorry.
What?
Chill out your shit.
Oh. Hey, you know what, folks? You can actually join the Fun Brigade now for $2.99 a month, folks. It's worth it at half the price, but folks, it's $2.99. That's less than a fucking cup of coffee these days, folks. And we've got merch. We've got, you know, and stuff. And we're monetized now. And we got super chats, and I'd like to thank everybody for last night. It was really touching, and I almost got a little emotional, but I didn't. So
where was I last night? I didn't know you were streaming.
You know, Adam had a lot to do with that, right, Grampy?
I know. You know, it was the other day.
That,
I was going to go live.
Loves you. That dude really loves you.
Oh, he's a good kid.
I like him a great deal.
But I was going to go live the other day, right? And Miss Parker and Black Eye TV and Dry? It was like everybody was on. I was like, fuck. So all of a sudden he goes, hey, why don't you go live Thursday at 8? I'm like, okay. So he goes, come up with a good name or something. I go, like what? I don't know. You know, he goes, and then when you said it, you were hijacking the stream and stuff, but I really do appreciate that. So anyway, that's it.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Nightmare.
I just want to say that Frank will eventually win in 10 years.
No, fuck
in
you, 10 Frank.
Years, but,
fuck you.
Yeah, no, but
Mom, Dad, don't fight like this.
We're fighting.
I know it's a divorce attorney. I'll send Frank the details.
Uncle Joey.
All right, no, you got your chance, Grampy. Give him his chance. Come on.
Sorry.
It's fine.
I love Grampy. I did a stream with Miss Parker earlier. We went over Cyrax's diss tracks, which was fucking god awful. Of course, you have my show, Your Internet Friends, and yeah, that's about it. Frank, you're gonna win in 10 years. I believe in you.
No, fuck you, suck it.
Anytime, suck it. Anytime, honey. Just
put your face into Grimace's pussy like Shanny. Fuck you.
What? Oh
my.
Damn, she's
I will shoot for a minute.
Where the fuck did that come from?
That escalated fast.
That's Tavs.
Yeah, no shit.
Y'all don't know me. Y'all don't know me. I'm going to win. Y'all don't even know my persistence. I'm going to win.
Frank, I'll give you the handcuffs. Just see what you got to do.
I'll put handcuffs. Listen, I'm going to stop talking.
Jello.
Yeah. hi, my name is Buck Melanoma. You should check out. Not. You should check out my band, The Haas, on YouTube.
Suck.
Hell yeah. Hey, go fuck yourself, Grampy. I'm plugging my band. We're a good time, feel good sort of music, and you should come check us out on our YouTube channel. Thank you.
There you go, Anna.
Oh shit. Yeah. Okay. So. I definitely want to, once again, just plug the stream that Tav's about to do. After that, I'm going to be doing a stream right after Tav's stream, which is going to be about an hour long. I'm going to be doing a stream with DC Media Girl, so go check that shit out. We're going to do an open call-in show. We're going to have some people who could call in. We're going to talk about some content. We're going to talk about Von Helton going off the fucking map, and I have a few other topics as well.
Can I call in and talk about Rev's butthole, or no?
No, we're not talking about Rev's butthole. We're not talking about Rev's butthole. No. We're not talking about Rev Spoof. Since Brad's not here, I do want to say something real fast. I want people to, you know, consider go like the fucking stream, support these guys for all the fucking hard work they do. Go sub to Frank's channel. Go sub to Crude as Fuck, because if this channel ever goes down for whatever reason because of YouTube fuckery, that's exactly where you're gonna want to go for all these streams and to stay up to date with all that type of shit. Go subscribe to Crude as Fuck. Get that to 1,000 subscribers so that we can get Super Chat and all that monetization shit enabled over there. Like the video, share this shit around, and next tomorrow we'll be back with the fucking salt mine. So stay.
And I won.
So is the geek room breaking up? What's on in there? Is the geek room breaking up?
I feel like my plug wasn't long enough now.
Oh god! Wait a minute.
Even though Ben Kirby's being mean, I'm gonna play this while we go out.
Ass titties, ass and titties, ass titties, ass and titties, ass 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 titties,